Hi students, today we are going to see lesson 4, Breton cycle or a constant pressure cycle. This cycle is called a Breton cycle because the name of the person who designed the cycle called Breton, and also it is called a constant pressure cycle because the heat addition and heat rejection takes place at a constant pressure. This cycle consists of 4 processes, 1 to 2 and 3 to 4 are isentropic processes, and 2 to 3 and 4 to 1 are constant pressure processes. Now let us see how to find the efficiency of Breton cycle. This is also, as usual, the ratio between work done and heat supplied. So work done is as usual heat supplied minus heat rejected. So finally we get the efficiency of Breton cycle is equal to 1 minus QR by QS, and heat supplied QS is MCP T3 minus T2, because it is at constant pressure between the temperatures. Maximum is T3, minimum is T2, so T3 minus T2. And similarly, the amount of heat rejected is MCP into T4 minus T1, because the maximum pressure is T4 and minimum pressure is T1, which takes place at constant pressure. Now let us substitute the equations 2 and 3 in the equation 1. We get 1 minus MCP T4 minus T1 divided by MCP T3 minus T2. In both numerator and denominator, MCP is constant, which gets cancelled. So finally we get the efficiency of Breton cycle is equal to 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T3 minus T2. Let us try to bring this expression in terms of the pressure ratio. So what is pressure ratio? The ratio between maximum pressure and minimum pressure during the cycle. So the maximum pressure is P2, P2 is also equal to P3, and minimum pressure is P1, P1 is also equal to P4. Therefore pressure ratio is P2 by P1, it is also equal to P3 by P4, because P1 is equal to P4 and P2 is equal to P3. In the process 1 to 2, isentropic compression process, so T2 by T1 is equal to P2 by P1 power gamma minus 1 by gamma. This is the relationship between temperature and pressure during the isentropic process, which we all know very well. Therefore, T2 is equal to T1 into P2 by P1 power gamma minus 1. This P2 by P1 is nothing but the pressure ratio. So we get T2 is equal to T1 into Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Let us take this as equation 5. When we consider the process 3 to 4, isentropic expansion process, so T3 by T4 is equal to P3 by P4 power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Therefore, T3 is equal to T4 into P3 by P4 power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Again, this P3 by P4 is nothing but pressure ratio. So we get T3 is equal to T4 into Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. Let us take this as equation 6. When we substitute equation 5 and 6 in the equation 4, we get efficiency of Breton cycle as 1 minus T4 minus T1 by T4 into Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma minus T1 into Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma. In both the terms, in the denominator, Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma is common. Let us take that commonly outside. We get 1 minus 1 by Rp power gamma minus 1 by gamma into T4 minus T1 by T4 minus T1, and hence these two terms gets cancelled. So finally we get efficiency of Breton cycle is equal to 1 minus 1 by Rp power. In Otto, Diesel, Dual and Breton cycles, we used to find the mean effective pressure. Let's see what is mean effective pressure. The average pressure acting on the piston during the power stroke is called mean effective pressure. We all know at the end of the compression stroke, in the case of petrol engine, spark plug gives a spark. In the case of diesel engine, fuel injector injects the fuel, and hence combustion takes place, due to which high pressure and high temperature gas is developed. This high pressure gas pushes the piston down. When the piston is at TDC, very high pressure is acting on the piston, and when it is moving down towards BDC, when it reaches BDC, very low pressure is acting on the piston. So during this expansion stroke or power stroke or working stroke, the average pressure which is acting on the piston is called mean effective pressure. we know what is work done. Work done is force under displacement. Here force is the gas force which is acting on the piston, and displacement is a movement of the piston between TDC and BDC. This is nothing but the stroke length L. So we get work done W is equal to force and the displacement L or stroke length. And how to find out the gas force? We know the gas pressure, mean effective pressure, is equal to force exerted by the gas divided by area of cross section. This area of cross section is nothing but the internal area of cross section of the engine cylinder, which is found by pi d squared by 4, where d is the dia of the cylinder or bore of the cylinder. So the gas force is equal to the product of gas pressure and the area of cross section of the cylinder. Let us substitute this in the place of 4. We get a mean effective pressure and area of cross section of the cylinder and the stroke length. We know the product of area of cross section of the cylinder and the stroke length is nothing but stroke volume, because the area of cross section and the stroke length gives you the swept volume or stroke volume. So finally we get W is equal to mean effective pressure and stroke volume. We want to find the mean effective pressure. Therefore mean effective pressure is a ratio between work done and the stroke volume. So the work done by stroke volume is, or swept volume, is nothing but the mean effective pressure. Thank you.